Thank you for that that kind introduction, Pastor. Isn't it good to be in God's house? Isn't it good to be vertical, alive, in good health? Amen. If we could say that tonight, and all of us who are able to be here certainly can say that. Our God is good, and we are very blessed. Amen. Give him all praise, all honor, and all glory before this ever gets started tonight. He is good, and he is faithful.
Take a ride at the mansion on Apostle Avenue. Turn left on Believer Boulevard. Once you pass Salvation Street, you'll hit Grand Pure as gold. You'll find me in a new home at the end of Gospel Road. Place called home. When I heard a preacher preaching, talking about Jesus, and the place I want to go. That's the day I found a new way home. So take a ride at the mansion on Apostle Avenue. Turn left on Believer Boulevard. And once you pass Salvation Street, you'll hit Grand Pure as gold. You'll find me in a new home at the end of Gospel Road.
I like this verse right here. It kind of fits me. I've never owned a big house in the finest part of town, just filled with fancy stuff. So with my little piece of heaven, we're just a quiet country acre. Lord knows that would be enough. Amen. And if you should ever want to look me up,
see me over there, amen.
At the end of Gospel Road,
it'll be prettier than 441.
At the end of Gospel Road, oh, I'm at the end of Gospel Road. At the end.
I've said this often when I was singing, especially up around this area. When I was with the Kingsmen, oftentimes that bus would roll into Swannanoa over there on the other side of Asheville in the wee early hours on Monday morning, and I had an automatic clock inside me. As soon as those tires stopped in Swannanoa, I popped up. It didn't matter what time of night it was. I was getting my stuff together, and I was getting in my little car and heading south and west toward Alabama. Oftentimes, when the sun would be coming up, I would see that smoke on top of these mountains around here. And I've often thought of that Bible verse where this life is compared to vapor. It's not long, Pastor, for any of it. It doesn't matter if we live to be 110. Eternity is coming and coming soon for all of us. This isn't life. This is just testing ground. Real life for a Christian is coming when we leave this place. Amen? I want to sing a song. I do just about each and every time I sing. This song is special to me. I was on the road with the Kingsmen somewhere 800 and something miles from home, and I got word that my sweet granny had slipped into eternity, and she had had a lot of health issues, and my grandfather had preceded her by about 15 years, and he's such a huge part of my testimony as well. I only had one set of grandparents, but God blessed me with a good set. And she had been in and out of these 21-day rehabilitation things at nursing homes when she would fall and break this and have to have surgery or have to have this done and that done, and she had just suffered for a long time those last several years, and I got word that she had slipped off into eternity, and I cried a little bit. I was just, my mind was just flooded with those memories, and then it dawned on me, she's not hurting anymore. She's never going to break anything else. She's not suffering. She's in the presence of my grandfather again. But most importantly, she's in the presence of Jesus Christ, because his word says to be absent of the body for a Christian is to be present with the Lord. Amen. I couldn't be sad anymore. And I'm thankful that God allowed me to get back just in time to sing this song at her home service. I pray that you'll listen to the words in this. At this point in the game, there's not a person in this building who hasn't lost someone who was near and dear to us. These words are true, folks, because I believe what God's word says about heaven. And knowing what I know about that place, I wouldn't bring my loved ones that are saved back here for anything. I bet the trumpets play and the angels sing every sweet refrain of amazing grace, and that heaven's hands opened up the gate, and that children danced when they saw your face. As happy as they were to see you coming, I was just as sad to have to watch you go. But oh, knowing what I know about heaven, believing that you're all the way home, knowing that you're somewhere better, that's all I need to let you go. Now I could hope that I could pray it back, but why on earth would I do that when you're somewhere like the love never been? Oh, knowing what I know about heaven, where every single voice makes a joyful noise, how sweet as the saints rejoice, to every broken heart and every wounded soul, new life begins on streets of gold. With every tear that's raining here from my eyes, I know the sun is shining where you are. And oh,
knowing what I know about heaven.
I'm thankful for that blessed hope and assurance. Amen. This next song I want to sing talks about our struggles and trials and things that we face here in this life. And boy, what an appropriate message in this day and time. The title of this song is When I Close My Eyes Here and Open Them at Jesus' Feet. All my trouble will be over. Amen, amen.
Since the day I was saved, there's been a longing in me to see Jesus face to face. He said that he would go and make a place for me, and there with him I could stay. Though the times are hard and the road is long, with him I'll walk on golden streets. When I close my eyes here and open them at Jesus' feet, the struggles down here that we have to bear can't be compared to the joy that's in store. Where pain is a stranger and there is no danger, it's glory forevermore. Sin has been conquered, our troubles are over, and death will go down in defeat. When I close my eyes here and open them at Jesus' feet, now I'm a little older, there's a stoop in my shoulder. Soon I'll pass through death's cold door. All the trials and temptations I face down here, I won't have to face anymore. I'm looking toward heaven and the face of my Savior. There my life will be complete. When I close my eyes here and open them at Jesus' feet. The struggles down here we have to bear can't be compared to the joy that's in store. Where pain is a stranger, there is no danger, it's glory forevermore. Sin has been conquered, our troubles are over, and death will go down at defeat. It's when I close my eyes here and open them at Jesus' feet. Yes, when I close my eyes here and open them at Jesus' feet.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, that's so true. Everybody awake in here.
There's a light in the window, the table set in splendor. Someone's standing by an open door. I can see a crystal river. Lord, I must be near forever. I've never been this homesick before. I see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see the Father standing at the door. This whole world. Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
Amen. The longer I'm here, the more homesick I get. This world is not my home church.
I can see the family gathering, sweet faces all familiar, but no one's old or feeble anymore. This so lonesome crying. I think I'll spread my wings for flying, 'cause I have never been this homesick before. I can see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see my Father standing at the door. See the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see my Father standing at the door. This world's been a wilderness, and I'm ready for deliverance. Oh Lord, I've never been this homesick before. See the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see the Father standing at the door. This world's been a wilderness, and I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. Come on, I see the bright.
Still will I stand in your presence until I need
knees? Will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only
sung this song a cappella at a graveside service of a dear sainted man of God. And the pastor conducting that service said something that day, as long as I'm in my right mind, I don't want to ever forget. And I sang that song, and before he said anything else, he said, no greater words have ever been penned in a song than that right there for what we're doing here today. How beautiful heaven truly must be. He said, I want to remind you all of something. No matter where you've been or what you've seen, no matter how amazing and grand and glorious and beautiful it was, God did it all in 6 days. Just 6 days. And this is the part that sent, we call them glory bumps in Alabama. They sent the glory bumps up and down my spine. He said it's been right at 2,000 years since he said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go through all that trouble, I'm going to come back and I'm going to bring you home with me to enjoy. We can only begin to imagine how beautiful heaven must be.
We read of a place that's called heaven. It's made for the pure and the free. These truths in God's word He have given. How beautiful heaven must be.
nor pining, no wishing for elsewhere to be. God's light is forever there shining, and how beautiful heaven must be.
Broke the thongs of prison.
I'm glory bound. Here we go, everybody.
I'm
June the 6th, 1984, Jesus Christ came into my heart, and I've never been the same. Hope and pray that everybody listening in this building, on the radio, in the parking lot, wherever you may be now or hereafter, knows that you know that you know that you're saved and on your way to heaven. This is a short song. I've been singing it as long as any I'll do tonight. John 3:16 tells us the answer, but the title of this song is Why? God so loved, tell me, as a Savior was walking up Calvary's hill, all the birds hushed their singing, and the leaves stood still, all the flowers of the field bowed their lovely heads as the Savior to Calvary was led. They put nails in his hands and they pierced his precious side. Oh, the pain so great that the tears filled his eyes, but he spoke not a word until the last breath he drew, then cried, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Oh, tell me why did Jesus die on Calvary? And tell me why did he suffer such agony? In the Lord with all thine heart, lean not on our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him, and he, what's the word, shall direct our paths. Doesn't say he'll try to, doesn't say he'll consider it. If we do our part on that deal, he'll do his. Amen. He's never told us a lie, and he never will. But I heard this song that spoke to me. Maybe it'll speak to someone tonight. I don't know what you're going through, but God does. He knows and he cares. Amen.
Master, may I be so honest? Could I admit the way I feel? I'm hurting. It seems that you've forsaken. God, I've wondered, is your love for me still real? Though my friends think I am happy, unaffected by this trial, they can't see the pain I'm hiding just underneath my smile. And Master, I can't live this way anymore. So today I make my choice. I choose to believe that you are faithful, that my heart is in your hands, and that this mystery that I face today is part of a greater plan. I choose not to be discouraged when the sun will not break through. I have the choice of trusting
what I choose.
I know this road will not be easy, and I know I'm gonna have my weaker days, and Satan will tell me I don't mean it when I say I'll trust God all the way. Oh, but that really doesn't matter, for I refuse to hear him out. With my faith I'll find the power that will overcome all doubt. And Lord, I've never been so strong as when I'm resting in your arms. I choose to believe that you are faithful, and that my heart is in your hands, that this mystery that I face today is part of a greater plan. I choose not to be discouraged when the sun will not break through. I have the choice of trusting you. So, Lord, this is what I choose. Today is part of a greater plan. I choose not to be discouraged when the sun will not break through. I have the choice of trusting you. So, Lord, this is what.
Just choose Jesus tonight, church. He's all that...